Is it possible to achieve both startability and high efficiency? This video demonstrates an innovative method and compares it with traditional vertical axis wind turbines. Although the lift-type vertical axis wind turbine is more efficient than the drag-type, it is too symmetrical and difficult to start by itself. After using the hand push to start, today's conditions can reach 120 RPM, which is used as the benchmark for this experiment. Traditionally, drag blades are used to assist in starting lift-type wind turbines. Today, two sizes of drag blades were prepared for experiments to see which one has the best effect. The left side are large drag blades, and the right side are small drag blades. Remove the block and the wind turbine begins to accelerate. The RPM above indicates the speed of the wind turbine. It seems that the acceleration on the left side is faster. As time goes by, the difference between the two sides becomes more obvious. After a while, when the left side reaches 50 RPM, the right side is less than 40 RPM. Therefore, the larger drag blade accelerates faster, indicating larger starting torque. After another period of time, the top speed of the large drag blades reaches about 108 RPM, and the top speed of the small drag blades is about 112 RPM, which is faster than the top speed of the large drag blades. Therefore, although the large drag blades start faster, the interference to the lift blades is more serious and the efficiency is reduced, so they are not as fast as the top speed of the small drag blades. Therefore, the startability and efficiency of drag blades will conflict with each other and be difficult to achieve at the same time. Slang saying, children make choices. In the adult world, they want it all. In fact, it's not that easy. There are usually two ways to achieve both startability and high efficiency. The first is to increase the degree of freedom, such as making the drag blade retractable, extending it when starting, and retracting it at high speed. The second is to adopt innovative approaches. This video completely abandons the drag blades and uses the Magnus effect to start the wind turbine. The relevant structures have been introduced in previous videos and will not be explained anymore. Just do the test. The left side is Magnus rotor starting, and the right side is drag blade starting. Start testing. The upper display shows RPM as the rotation speed, PWM high as the rotor throttle, set at 66%. Preliminarily, the acceleration of the new method on the left is significantly faster than that of the drag blade on the right. After a while, the rotation speed of the new method has reached 60 RPM. While that of the large drag blade is only 37, and that of the small drag blade is only 33. After the wind turbine is started, the Magnus rotor can stop rotating without consuming electricity, and then the wind turbine can be accelerated by the lift blade. After a while, the top speed of the new method has reached 114 RPM, which is faster than the top speed of the small drag blade of 112 RPM. According to the experimental results, the use of Magnus rotors is better than traditional drag blades in terms of startability and top speed. Can it continue to improve? The top speed of the new method is obviously limited by the drag of the rotor, so the size of the rotor can be reduced to decrease the drag. However, reducing the size of the rotor will reduce the starting torque, but fortunately there is one more degree of freedom, which is the rotation of the rotor. Therefore, the torque can be compensated by increasing the rotation speed of the rotor. In addition, the exposed motor also suffers some drag and must be hidden. Modification completed, the left side is the modified short rotor, and the right side is the original long rotor. Start testing. Since the area of the short rotor becomes smaller, the speed must be increased. Therefore, the throttle of the short rotor is increased to 99% to maintain sufficient starting torque. After a while, the short rotor seems to accelerate a little slower than the long rotor, but about the same. Subsequently, the short rotor's top speed can exceed 117 RPM, which is faster than the long rotor's top speed of 114, and closer to the pure lift blade's top speed of 120. Save the data and import it into Excel. Observe the data of the short rotor and compare it with the drag blade. In the acceleration section of 0 to 50 RPM, compared with the large, small drag blades, the short rotor reduces the time by 22 and 41 seconds respectively. And the calculated starting torque increases by 45% and 85% respectively, which is a significant improvement. Then comparing the top speed of pure lift blades of 120 RPM, the top speeds of large and small drag blades dropped by 10% and 6.7% respectively, and the short rotor only dropped by 2.5%. So the efficiency is relatively high. Therefore, through continuous innovation, the startability and high efficiency of vertical axis wind turbines can be met at the same time. The project data used in this experiment are placed in the link below the video. Those who are interested can refer to it.